Good evening to all of you. In our today's session, we are going to study about the friend functions in C++. We have been emphasizing throughout the previous lectures that the private member functions cannot be accessed from outside the class. That is, a non-member functions cannot have access to the private data of the class. Nobody from outside the class can have direct access to the private data of the class. However, there could be a situation where we would be like to have two classes to share a particular function. For example, consider a case where two classes, manager and scientist, have been defined, and we would like to use the function income tax to operate on the objects of both the classes. In such situation, C++ allows the common function to be made friendly with both the class objects, thereby allowing the function to have access to the private data of these classes. Such a function will going to access the private data of both the classes and access it as well as operate it. Okay, so in C++, this is the only function, friend function, which violates the rule of data hiding. This is the function which accesses the private data of the class. Now, a question may come to your mind, how to declare any function or how to make any function as a friend function of the class. We need to just write the keyword friend inside of that particular function that we wanted to make it as a friend of that particular class. So, this is a small example given here. In class ABC, in public section, if you see, there is a function declared XYZ, and in front of that function, there was a keyword friend written here. It means that this XYZ function is the friend function of class ABC, and this function can have direct access to this private area of this class. Okay, so remember one thing about friend functions, that friend functions are those functions which are not belonging to any class, but they can access to the private data of the class. So after this, you must remember the characteristics of friend function. The first important characteristic is it is not in the scope of the class to which it has been declared as friend. Though if you see in above example, it has been declared inside the class, it doesn't mean that it belongs to that class. It is not in the scope of the class. It is an outside function that can have access to the private data of the class. So the first property says that it is not in the scope of the class to which it has been declared as friend. Second important point is about the characteristics is, since it is not in the scope of the class, it cannot be called using the object of that class. Remember one thing, if the member function is in the scope of the class, it means that function belongs to the class, and any object of that class can have direct access to the member function, correct? But in this case, in friend functions, it does not belong to the class, it is not in the scope of the class. It means that the object of the class cannot call any friend function of that class. Third characteristic is, it can be invoked like a normal function without the help of any object. It means we can call any friend function like a normal function that we seen in C programming language, and how we called any normal function, we know that, right? So all the friend functions can be called normally. Next is property is, unlike member functions, it cannot access the member names directly and has to use the object name and dot operator to access the members of the class, like a dot x written here. A is the object and the x is the field of the class, data member of the class. Okay. To access the private area of the class, it always takes object as an argument, and through the object, it can access the fields of the class. a dot x like this. Okay. The next property is it can be declared either in public or a private part of the class without affecting its meaning. It means you can declare the friend function anywhere inside the class. It doesn't change the meaning of the membership labels because it is an outside function. The compiler treats all the function friend functions as outside functions, but these functions access the private data of the class. Then the last property is usually it has objects as an argument. Remember one thing about friend function, it always take object of the class as an argument. Okay, so you have to remember all these important properties of friend function. Now we'll see a small program using friend function. Here there is a class sample in which there are variable declared a and b, integer a and integer b, in the private area of the class, correct? In the public area, we'll take an input function which initialize the values to a and b variable, that is set value. You can give any name to the input function. Okay, so inside that function we assigned a equal to 25 and b equal to 40. There is another function which is responsible for finding mean value of these variables, but it is declared as friend here. And if you notice here, there is a variable s of sample type. It means it is the object of sample class. Mean is the friend function which takes the object as a parameter here. Now we'll define the function outside the class. But if you see, when we define the member functions outside the class, there we use the class name and scope relation operator. We take the help of class name and scope relation operator. But now if you see in this example, we are defining friend function outside the class, but we are not writing here the class name and scope relation operator. It means that this function does not belong to the class sample. This is an outside function, no matter it has been declared inside the class. It's a friend function and it has to be defined like a normal function that we studied in C programming language. Okay. So the function float is defined here, and through the object S, we can access A and B values of the class. So in the return statement, we are writing float of s.a plus s.b divided by 2.0, which is actually calculating the average of or mean of two numbers. So this is the friend function which is responsible for finding the mean of two numbers. In the main program, we'll create the object of the class and we'll just call a set value function through the x object, x.set value. The function gets called and the values are set to 25 and 40. And there is another line which displays the mean value, and inside that there is a call goes to the mean function. And if you notice here, we have not used the object to call this function. All the friend function must be called like a normal function that we called in C programming language. If you see, there is no object before this mean function, correct? And at last we close the program. So this is the small program where we have illustrated how to access the private members through the friend function, correct? So there is a friend function mean which accessed values of a and b directly through the object s. Okay, so this ends the lecture on the friend functions in C++. Now in this example, we have only seen only one class, and we tried to access the features of or private features of the single class. Now I will see another example where there may be a more than one class, and we are accessing a member function is declared as friend function, which is common to more than one classes, and it is going to access some features of one class, some features of another class, and it is working on it, operating on it, and displaying some results. So in our next program on friend function, we have two classes here. So we have two classes ABC and XYZ. If you see here, a class is declared ABC and just terminated by a semicolon. This type of declaration of a class is called as formal declaration. Sometimes we just declare and we define later, and this thing is called as forward declaration. Okay, so here class ABC is the forward declaration. Then we defined a class XYZ where we have one variable x into the private area, and with the help of set value function in public section, we are assigning the value to x. That is the value of I. Okay, there is a function max which is friend to this class XYZ, and see how it has been written here. Friend void max XYZ comma ABC semicolon. It means that this is the max function which is going to take the object values of two different classes and operating on it. Okay, so this close the first class, and later on we define ABC class, and in that there is another variable A. Again we have a set value function where I is assigned to value A, and again there is one function that is friend to this class. So if you see, again the same definition is there, friend function definition is there inside class B, friend void max XYZ comma ABC. It means that this is the function which is common to both the classes, a friend function which is common to both the classes, and it is taking some features of one class, some features of another class, and operating on it. Correct. Now we'll see the definition of max function which was declared friend to both the classes ABC and XYZ. Now see the definition of max function. XYZ is the class and M is the object of the class. ABC is the another class and N is the object of the class. It means it has two objects of different classes as a parameter. And there is a code which checks which object is larger. M dot X is greater than or equal to N dot A. If this is true, we'll print first object is largest. Otherwise, we are going to print second object is largest, n dot a, and we close the function. Now, we will go to the main program. First of all, we will declare the object of the class and we set the values with the help of set value function defined inside the class. So, abc and small abc is the object of that class. So, abc dot set value will going to assign 10 to the first object, and XYZ dot set value will going to assign 20 to the second object. And if you pass the values here to the max function during the call, a normal call to the max function, XYZ comma ABC, it shows that the largest value among these two objects, and the output would be 20 here. Okay, so output of this program is 20. Now, have you noticed into this program we had two different classes, two different objects have been passed to the common function which was made friendly to both these classes, and the responsibility of the friend function was to tell which is the largest object among two different objects passed to it. So here you understood that we can have one function made friendly to many classes, and the friend function can access the private data of many classes to whom it has been declared as friend. Okay, so this ends your session on friend functions. Thank you for watching this video.